Okay, so I got questioned on my YouTube. Got a question asking how you transition scenes. Let's see, make this bigger. Everyone can see. Let's see, savage level. How do we get to the text? Onlygoodsir, nice to see you again. I've met some problems about how to transfer a scene to another by a click button. I've tried many ways using ventuz 5, but issues come up when I open runtime. So can you make a tutorial about scene transition? Sorry about my poor English. I came from Taiwan. That's cool. Your English is fine. I understand. And we can do F11. Let's zoom back out to 100%. There we go. Yeah, we can fix that. So what we can do, we can make a little graphic and you click it and it will go to, and then we transition to another scene. There's quite a few ways you can do it. You've got your slide manager. If you have never seen this before, it's worth looking at. If you click it and hit F1, there's an interactive example of slide manager, and you can transition. So you can see here, if I click on it, these are the containers that have different elements of a scene in it. Go next. Really simple. I can show you how to do this. Last reset slide manager. So slide manager is one way you can transition between different scenes. So here you can see these are the slices, but I can show you that. And then the other way is you can build your own, but not using the slice manager, but you can just I'll try to show it. It's hard to explain, but you'll probably see how this normally sometimes it depends on this simple project. I'll use a slide manager. If it's something more complicated, then I might not use the slide manager. So let's start with axis. I want a background image for the song. I could use a background image, a layer as a background image, but I want it in the scene, because I want to animate that too. In the same thing. Color. I'm gonna get a rectangle. Okay. I'm gonna just say 16:9 and scale this up. Fits the screen. I need a texture, so I'm just gonna get Google a texture. I've got tabs open. London City Skyline or something like this. Doesn't matter, as long as it looks cool. Night one looks nice. Let's see. Let's get which one? Oh, I want the clouds. Cloudy. Ah, I spelled cloudy wrong. That's fine. Want some clouds? Oh, that's too small. Let's go back. Let's get one of these night ones. Mm-hmm. Let's just take this. Or this one. It's too busy. Want something clean. Yeah, let's take this one. View image. Save image. Yeah. Just put it on my desktop. Yeah, that's saved. And close this window. I'm gonna load this in. Got my window open. Yeah, I got my chat window open. So let's load this texture in. Okay, so add texture base. Yeah, that'll move my texture. Just on my desktop somewhere. It's just the background. I just thought I'd create something, but let's see, where is it? Where's the bloody city one gone? Where are you? Sort by date modified. There we go. City. Okay. We have a picture there. Okay. There's our background. I'm gonna tint it a little. Let's just darken the base color. Just add a little. So it's a bit, because it's too bright for me. But it's just an example. I'm not going to design it properly, so I'm going to make get another axis. I'm going to go like this, and I'm going to get text. I'm just going to use 2D text for now. Block text. I'm going to call this start. Might be hard to see right now. There's this, says start. Yeah, you can choose a nicer font if you want. Let's see if we've got a font. Okay. I don't like this font for this style, but you'll do. Make sure you put character spacing. Let me block this now for now, so I can focus on this for now. So start, this is just the background. I'm gonna call this BG, so I know it's my background. This I'll just call start. This will be my start button. Okay, and I'm just gonna get an axis, rounded rectangle. Just gonna scale this up like that. Untick the field. So now we've got a hole. Something like this. Okay. Should I show you the slide manager first? And then show you. Yeah, maybe that might help. Yeah, it's probably better. I'm gonna put this all into one slide manager, into the slide manager. So it'll be easier. So grab the slide manager, drop it in. I've got my slides. If I want to add more, down here in the bottom right, I don't know if you can see on the stream, but here in the bottom right, you can append the slide, so you can add and you can remove the slide. So if I press remove, remove slide, you can see the slides are removing. If I add a slide, add slides. So I added more slots. And then if I want to add a new slide into that, I can just drag the slide here and drop it in, and these are empty. So right now I'm on 0, and let's reduce the slides because I don't need that many for an example. So we're on 0, slide 0. So this is our first slide. I'm gonna go into this container and paste the stuff in here that I was doing. So this background I'm not gonna put in the slide, I'm gonna put it outside the slide manager. So this will be my background. So I'm gonna put that at the top of my tree, behind the slides. So you can still see my start there. And what we can do, if I go into here, I'm gonna start animating. I'm not actually sure how to call this start. Maybe I'll give it a title or something. I'm gonna give this a title. Nice name. Let's untick field. I'm gonna just make something a bit nicer. Let's get text. I should have kept my text, why didn't I? Yep. Duty text, please. Block text. And let's call this like something like something. I don't know. Let's see.
Audio jungle.
Let's see what we've got here. Unchecking. Okay. Motion design. We're gonna call that motion design. I'm looking at a reference on the side. Motion design. Design. Yeah, I'm gonna center that text. So let me move this here so you can see the content window. Center it. Okay. Reset that. Okay. Scale this down. Something like this will do. Alright. This is gonna come out for you. We'll see. Hopefully. Can go into here, change the headline so the font's slightly bigger. Character spacing might bring in slightly. There we go. I think that's okay. Then I'm gonna call this line one, and then I got line two. I duplicated it. Just rename that line two. I'll move this font down here. Just call this smooth animation or something. Whatever we want. It can be a nice and long title. A long title. Okay. Let's scale this down. Not this. Scale the second line down. So it sits within this. Okay. Bring it up here. And then I'm gonna mask out the text into this rectangle. So I'm gonna use the stencil. Have I got my chat window open? Yeah, my chat window is open. Okay, there's my stencil set and test stencil set. So test stencil. I always get confused which way round. It's very easy to. Does that invert? No. Maybe it's the other way around. Very easy to get mixed up. There, one. There we go. So now you can see we're masking out the text. So there we go. Hopefully that looks cool. From this one, I feel like, yeah, that's better. I just took down the alpha of that background there. I'll just go back into this container. So we're gonna create an animation, and we're gonna have three states: begin, presented, end. Okay, so let's do some keyframing. So, keyframe animation. With the slide manager, it's always begin, presented, end. I think you can do a bit more complicated, but this is the easiest way I know. Ventuz also have tutorials on this on their website and on the YouTube channel. It's worth checking out. So go into 1 second. I'll set the key. So this is the end frame. Our start frame will be 0. So we're going, so we're revealing this second line of text. So you can see here. Press play. There you go. Probably quicker. Yeah. And then this text, this first line of text, I want to rise up. Rise. So Something like that. Okay. I might have to mask this as well, but I'll first start animating it and then mask it. So I've got the Y position there. I'm gonna set my keys and then I'll change the beginning. So my end key is already set. So the start. Right, let's move this here. So Y position. Yeah, there. Okay. So that opens and that rises. Okay. So now we're gonna mask the motion design text. So line one. I can just take this. I'm gonna drag this over here and get another axis, a rectangle, and I'm gonna use this one for this mask for the text for this the big title called motion design or whatever. Line one. I'll use this test over here. You can see now we got issue where we're using this is on layer one, so we need to set these on layer two so that we don't clash with the masks like that. And also you want it invert. Is it invert? Yeah, it might be the other way around now. Because as that rises, yeah, you want it the other way around. So let's swap this around. That goes there, and that one goes there, and that one goes above there. All right, is that right? Yeah, that's right. Okay, there we go. Bit confusing with the masks, but when you play around with it, hopefully you understand. Okay, it's gonna be quicker. Okay, so just the begin, in, and then we need to make an out transition, like an animation to transition out. What we can do, we can just reverse these keys, or so basically add another key there. This goes down, so a key here, and here, and zero this out. So we've got in to out, and these two. I want those to be linear in between. I'm just going to make sure these keys are linear, set to linear. Oh, and this one, linear. Hey, is it linear? Yeah, okay. That's fine. So, bang, out. So that'll do, but the animation is not going to be perfect. Hang on, I should go to 1.5 for the center because I'm at 3 seconds here. Let's just get this even spread evenly. Let's see. Let's see this. That'll do. We can speed this up anyway. Okay. So let's set our states. So really simple. Go into my gonna go here. Click in new. You can do soft state or hard state. I'm gonna just do a soft state for this one. S1. S2 and S3. I'll do it this because I can move this around and then the keys won't be locked to like a hard state. It allows me to edit these easier. So the green, you can see green, begin. The yellow is presented and the orange is end, the end of the slide. So if I go here, begin, I'll just name them begin so we understand. Begin, presented, end. I can change this as well if I wanted. So if I press N, it will go normal, so blue. If I wanted that to be the end, that could be E, or and P on the keyboard makes it presented. If that makes sense. So, yeah, hopefully it makes sense. So next, previous, next. So begin, presented, end. So now if we go here to our timeline, we go next. And then end. We can speed up the time by shortening the keyframes. I'm just going to change the global speed on this. So if I increase it by 250, 200. Slide manager's gone to the next one because we went to the end. Okay, let's see if this works. Yeah, I just increased, doubled the speed. Okay, so that's our first slide done. So you can see now, if I go here to the slide manager, so I'll go to begin. So next, we're on the presented state of this slide. And then if I go next again, it'll take us out and you'll see, it should go to, yeah, it's gone to this one, the next slide down. It just didn't refresh quick enough. But yeah, now the next slide is empty as well. So what we can do, let's see, what can we do? We can have a bit of information or picture, I don't know. So on this slide, we can say, okay, we transitioned now to another scene. So text, 2D text, block text. Let me get some. Is it lip? Lip some text or something like that. Dummy text. Yeah, lip some. So I'm going to just take some of this dummy text. Okay. Doesn't actually mean anything. It looks like text. I'm going to paste it in here. I'm going to just change the width. We've got some writing. It's a bit too much, but I doesn't matter. So we can have that. And then we can grab a rectangle. Okay. And get a color. And then we're going to put texture there. So this can be like an image next to it. Okay. So let's add a texture. Base. I'm going to pick a picture. Any picture? Okay, we got a picture of a cat. Let's use that. There we go. So now we need to animate this. So again, I'm gonna add some text effects on this one. Text effects. You can do whatever animations you want. Doesn't matter. I'm just trying to keep this nice and simple right now. So. Oh, I'm thinking, how should I bring this on? I want to bring it on in an interesting way. Yeah, it doesn't match it. I'll keep it really simple. Yeah. Okay. So I'm going to animate the position of that. So get another keyframe animation. We're going to animate this. It would maybe just fly in for now. And we can always change this later, or I'll just drop in a few X's so we can change in later on. I'll show you what I mean. So I'm going to set the my presented keyframe. So let me go and say, so say at 0.8, this is what I want everything to be looking like, and at the start, no text, and this image flares is out, is off screen, so it's not, doesn't, is not visible. As I come in, and then as I go out, somewhere like there, take this out, zero. So in, out. Pretty simple. Nothing fancy. And then I'm going to set some states. I'm just going to do the S1, S2, S3. Shortcut Shift S. Shift S is for the soft states, S is for a hard state. And you can see it's already given doing this for us. So I don't even have to set these. So that begin, presented, end. You can name these again if you want. Begin. Or you can give them actual titles, what they are. So it could be like image one or whatever you want. Or you could, but just to make it more easier to understand, just call it presented. And then so you can get used to the what the yellow means presented. It's here, present, and. Okay, in, out. Not complicated animation, really simple. And you can see now already we've got the transitions going on. So actually, if I click on the with the slide manager, I forgot, if I just click now on the screen, is it? Yeah, there was a delay there. It's, I don't know why there's a delay. Anyone, but when you click on it, you can see the animation is triggered automatically. Yeah, there is a delay, that is a long delay between the switch. Let's say, what happens if I change the world speed to 5? Previous, there we go, that's a long delay. Let's say, and neighbors. What happens if I change it to 2? Previous. Next. That's, I've never seen it go that slow. I don't know why it's going that slow between the slides, but yeah. Anyway, it's working anyway. The next and previous. Eventually it appears. Okay, I don't know if that's the animation. I can just double check. It might be just my time, but I'm not sure in seconds. That's 1 second. It's less than a second, so maybe I can speed up this 200. Let's just double check. But I've never seen it go that slow. Reset that. Option world speed. Let's say 1. Yeah, I don't even know why there's such a long delay between these. Anyway, but you can see. So now, if I delete these next two slides, so say we go. So now we go next. We've transitioned out to the next one. And then I could drag this one in and drag this in again. Then I can go into this slide here, change the picture. So let's get this upper cap that we've got here. Let's just fix the mapping. Do the mapping. I'm just gonna correct that. There we go. And I'm gonna change the animation. So all I've done is duplicate, and then I'll make some slight changes. So the begin, maybe let me just copy that value. Maybe it flies in like that. So already you can see, and go next, next, come on, there we go. Or I can go previous, let's just use inside manager. And then if we go next again, there we go. And then this one I can edit again. It can be completely different. Oh, I could just remove some text just so we can see there's a difference. Maybe even smaller. Let me just open the text box, easier. Where's the text wrap? There we go. Where's the text editor? Position that like that. Maybe this has a different rotation like that. Something like this. You can see this is cutting into the background space of this. So what I could do is I could put this on a this could have been actually a different layer in here. I was going to try to say viewport, and I'm thinking version 4, but yeah, you'd have to do it using the layers. For now, I'm just going to push this back. I did like viewports, they're actually useful, but the new layer system, I guess, is the same thing. Yeah, so let's move this like that. There we go. So it's not nothing fancy. I ain't built nothing fancy. I'm just using what we've got. Okay, the start is not good on that one, as you can see the out. There we go. So if I click, all I'm doing is saying click, you can see here when I click, current state, next one. Yeah, there we go. So you also have, if I go begin, presentation reset, next, previous. You can jump to the presentation, the slides. I think you can say use it. I think that accepts event. What's it? Arguments. Let me just check. I don't remember. So if I change that to argument, say 2, that's a really good test. So you reset. Does it take the event argument? Was it? I thought it would take the event argument. I'm sure it does take the event argument. Or somewhere. Let's just check the example. It's always good to look at the interactive scene. Reset. Next slide. I'm sure you could say jump to an event though. It doesn't have an example, but I'm sure you can use the event argument to jump to a slide. Whether it was here or here, I don't know if it would be in the reset. What happens if I say next slide? Is that just taking me to one? Yeah. Just double check. Yeah, no, that's not doing it. And there's a way to do it, but I just don't remember. I'll find that for you, or maybe somebody can help out in the comments below after the video's uploaded on YouTube. Okay, so that's one way anyway. Slide manager, really useful. So next. So what you can do, you can link buttons to these. So I could just get an axis, and get a touch button. So if I just get a rectangle or something for now, so this can be our first button. Put one here. Let's put one here on the left. Just make it really easy. So let's say that's your one button. And this is your two button. This is your previous. So previous and next. Actually, I could do this. Let me use a circle. Circle. Reduce the test set. Put a hole in them. Reduce the tessellation. There we go. So previous. Let's rotate you that way. Oh, 180. There we go. So this can be linked to our previous, and this can be linked to our next. And of course, we want these in front of our graphics as well. So just gonna move them closer, shrink it in. Where are they? Oh, there they are. Okay. I'm going to move the previous to the left and the next to the right. Okay, and then all I'm going to do is take the next and previous and slide manager. Next goes to next. I'm going to just do a single tap. Previous goes to previous. Single tap. There we go. What happened to this slide? Oh, we was on this side. Okay. Oh yeah, we can also turn on wrap so it will loop. So that's why we got to the end and nothing happened. We just went out. So now we're back to the start. We can go next. And you can see here we're going through, cycling through the presentation. So I've got next and we can go back. Go back. Why is it not going back? Did I link this wrong? Let me check. Single tap. Single tap. Okay. So there you go. Oh. Take out the input enabled. Uncheck that. Because then if I click, it won't trigger. But if I had that, when I had that checked, it was triggering. So you just uncheck that. So now only the buttons will trigger the slide manager. So now you can see I'm going back and forth. Okay. Hopefully that's one way of explaining it. Now the other way is, I'm not going to use slide manager. I'm just going to go in here. So I'm going to cut this. I'm going to block this for now. Block this. Block this. Block this. I'm going to make a group. And paste it in here. There's so many ways you can do it. I mean, so I can call this is my start. So I'll say this is my start container. I'm making my own containers, and then what I could do is, so I know I've got like my ins and outs, animate in, animate out. Okay, I'm gonna just merge that into a container. And what I could do is I can expose the control. And I can call that, when you double click here, and then I can call it my expose string start. So let's say that's one container. So we can do the same thing here, but it's a bit more easier. I prefer doing my own containers, but for simple projects you can use this. I'm just gonna take this cat thing that we got. Just gonna copy that. I'm just gonna make another group. Say this is my second container, and then I'm just gonna paste that into there, into this group, merge the container. I'm just going to say cat one, and then in that one I'm going to expose the same, the control. You can call it what you want, cat one or whatever you want, as long as you know what it is. I'm going to expose the texture out of this, so I don't have to keep on jumping back in. So I'm going to expose the texture file. Okay, and we can expose the text as well if we wanted. So now here we can just change the file name. So if I duplicate this to cat2, and then I change this, and then I can go, let's get something else. Okay, got this one screenshot. Okay, it's not a cat, but a. Okay, so ignore this stuff. Actually, I'll just delete this slide, delete all this. We don't need that. It's just going to confuse. So right now we've got start container. It's the same what we had in the slide manager, but they're just in our own containers. This cat2 and cat1. And what I want to do is link them with a keyframe animation. And I'm just going to key the, so grab the exposed controls. So this one, start, cat1, cat2, and this animation node. Then in the animation node, what I'll do is set keys. So 1 second. So insert. So this state, nothing. Then here, so it'll be state begins presented. So you can see here. And then this one, connection presented to end. So you can see in, out. It's hard to see with the other graphics overlapping. So if I block these two, so you can see. So that's the first one. So as that one comes in, the other one goes out. And then this one, connection, I can do begin to presented. So begin. So that one goes in, and then that one goes out. Is it? Yeah. Why can't I see this one? Oh yeah, because I blocked it. Yeah, that's very silly of me. So let's unblock these. So I block this one now. So you can see that one goes in, that one comes out. So this is doing the transition. This is, so we got more control to do the transition. So we can do all sorts. So we can mess around with the timing. So this one can come in just as this one's finished. So you can mess around. But I'm just gonna keep it simple, like this. And then the next one. So I'm just gonna set another keys. So set key, insert. This one will be presented to end. So that one goes out, and this one will be connection. That's it, begins as presented. So that goes out, next one comes in. If I unblock that, so you can see, like out, next one's in. Okay, so you can see here we're just doing it in the timeline. And of course then we can say, oh, okay, this animates out as well. So just add a keyframe for you and then say presented to end. So it's gone out. I'm just gonna add a key here and here, and that'll be end, of course. Oh, end. Okay, and these would be state begin, state begin. There we go. Okay, so then what I can do is set up my states. I'm going to just do hard states on this, and you'll see why. So S1, so in, after that one to S2, then S3, and then S4, out. So I can call S1, I'm just going to call start, and S2, I'll call, I'm just going to call this page 1, and this one, page 2, I'm going to call it. And then I've got this one, I'm going to call page 3, and then I'm going to call this one out. Okay, so right now it's a linear timeline, it's just going forwards and backwards. It's not going, we're not saying, oh, if I click this I want to jump to this page. Right now it's just very linear, and you can see here, if I turn this on, you can see in the on the direction that we're traveling. So you can see as it highlights, you can see which page we'll jump into. 2, 3, 4, out. Now what you could do with the logic is you can connect each one to itself and figure out all the possibilities. If I click on page 3 and I want to go back to page 2 or jump back to page 1, and then you can figure out all that logic yourself, or because ventuz made this amazing auto connect states, you can just say click the auto connect and they figure out, they'll do all the logic for you. So I'm just say overwrite existing ones because this is, and then create animation rules auto all. Also you can create jump states as well if you want to just jump straight into that state. So hit OK, and you can see it's done all the possible connections for me, and then it's created here the slices, the transitions between the slices as well, which is amazing. Okay, so it saves me a lot of work, it saves you a lot of work as well. So if we're going to say, okay, so we know it's page 2 to start, so page 2 to start, so the start is nothing, and then so we say okay, page 2, which was page 2 is the cat 2, so I'm going to change that to, so it should be presented to begin on this connection, like so. Hang on, what's, why have I got a flicker there? Yeah, because this one should be presented. So here, this one should be end. There we go. So if we go here, no, this is wrong. I've edited it wrong. Ignore this. So page 1 goes there to there, and this one should be connection presented to, no, begin to present it. Oh, it's this one, sorry, begin to present it, yeah, and then this one should be presented to end, like so. And this one should be, or is it, begin to present it. So that one goes out, that one goes in. Yeah. Okay. That looks right. Out. Out to page 2. So where's page 2? It's this one. Connection. Out to page 2 should be presented. Begin to present it. Is that right? Yeah. So now if we go here, I think the, I've confused myself. One second. To make my life easier, because I use these states within the states, I've confused myself, when I could have just done simple control and it made my life easier. So what I'm going to do, just to amend this, and I'm just going to delete these slices. Delete these slices. To delete the slices, you'll find it up here. Delete current slice. I should just delete the whole keyframe animation. Doesn't matter. In here, I'm just going to remove the states from here. I find this way this will be a lot easier for me. I'm going to use a simple control. Uncheck that. Drag the control to the simple and expose the progress, because then I know 0 to 100 and then 50 is the middle, so the animation for me, that's easier. Then I don't have to do the ins and outs presented and stuff like this. So again, the same, drag that there, expose this. Might not be the right way to do it, but it's a different way to do it. Everyone's got their own workflow, I guess. But yeah, for me that was a bit. I can delete these. Actually, those wouldn't even really matter because I'm not using them, but I'll just delete them anyway. Delete that. There we go. So now I've got my free progress keyframe. Okay, I'm gonna drag all those into here. This will be actually a lot easier. 1 second. So set key, go to 1 second. Set 50. Set key, go to 2 seconds. That would go to 100, and then that would be at 50. Set a key. Can you see what I'm doing? How easy that was for me, because I know the simple control is 0 to 100, so I don't have to worry about the going between the states. For me, it's easier to work out. So then I'll go here, and then this one would be of course 100, because that would be the end of the animation, and then this one would animate in, which would be 50, halfway, and then out again, so this would be 100. And then on the slices now, I don't have to do the right click. So if I set the states, S1, S2, S3, S4, S5, and then if I go to my states, I'm just going to call that again. Call that start, page 1, page 2, end, and then we click the auto connect. Hit OK. Go here. Now if I go here on the properties, you can see there page 1. So if I hit start, now animate from page 1 to start. If I want to go from start to page 2, you can see I've got a transition there and begin. And now you can see we've got that weird overlapping issue here. But I can jump between any of these and it will transition, because it's using it, the logic's all worked out. So all we have to do is just amend this in between slices. So it goes begin to page 1 and page 1 to out. So page 1 to out. Hang on, what's going on here? So page 2. Oh, I see what's going on. It's going from 0 to 100. And we don't want to do that. So what I could do, this last key here, if I go into further second or like this, I can just change that to 0 at the key, and you won't notice. Hopefully no one will notice it. There you go. And I got the same on the start as well. So page 1 to end. Is it on page 1 to end? Yeah. And of course, it's the same one here. So page one to begin, other one that to animate. So again, I'm gonna just add a key 100. Set key. There we go. So the begin to page one now is just that. Again, begin to page two. I've got these going crazy. So page two, there should be 100. Okay. So I'm just gonna go one frame in and just set these to 100 already. Again, this is not the right way, but it's a way. Of course, people do it differently. I've done differently as well. Every project I've done is different. I don't have one way of doing something. So here, what's this? This is end to end. Begin to end. So really, they can just all stay 100. There you go. Oh, I forgot to put on this one. You can see I'm doing it one frame in before, so I don't affect the main logic on the timeline. Begin to end, so then start to page two. Start to page two. So cat one is interfering. So I'm just gonna add that one keyframe for that one. 100. Set key. Oh man. Just before. 100. Set key. There we go. And of course, you can always. You see how we've got this overlapping here? If I wanted to say, okay, the start ends here, I can move this key in. And. What was it? It's cat 2. I can move that out. So I can say, okay, that just goes and then that one comes in. So I can play around with the timings. So I can bring those like that. There you go. And then we've got start to end. I thought we had to enter, we have begin to end, but we have start to end. So again, this doesn't need to do anything. So you can do, they can all be 100. 100, 100, 100. There we go. Yep. Start. Why start on 50? Oh no, that's right. So start doesn't need that key. Start to end. Yeah. There we go. And also you can speed up the times for each one, so the transition, so it doesn't have to be the same. So I can say, oh, if there's half a second to start to end, then it's fine. So now if I go here, we can transition between all of these. You can see how easy it is. Okay. So now I'm transitioning. For me, it's easier to understand 0 to 100, but you can do states, but then it won't, yeah, it's really up to you how you want to do it. So I can call this main. So now say I want a set of buttons to control my states, so I can get an axis, touch button, get a rectangle, I'm gonna just put a like this, actually, yeah, that'll do. I'm just gonna get a few buttons. So how many we got? We've got three states, so 1, 2, 3. So we've got three pages to jump between. We'll make an exit one or something. Okay, so 1, 2, 3. So what I can do is go here, select that, just position these. So I can take start, Start can be one, single tap. Page one can be two, link to two, single tap. Page two, button three, single tap. So now if I click, I'm transitioning between different scenes. They're all in the same scene. But it looks like the transition. So I can go from 3 to 1 to 2 to 1 and so on. And of course the animation, you can see how quick I can click. And if I had more buttons, then I could link the end, I say take everything out, so I could make a close button. We could do that now if we want, so we can just say close or something and then just put it up in the right. This is a really basic example, and it's not, might not be the right way of doing it. And like I said, I'm not saying this is the way you should do it. You might find a better way of doing it, but this works for me. So now if I go here and say end, take it out. Go here, end, close, open, close, open, close, open, close. And I could say on scene event, say on scene event, I could say, actually I could take auto begin off. I would take auto begin off and I would say I want it to start on that. So on scene event, I'll grab the start and link it to that. So if I save as example one, okay, that'll do. And then export presentation to the desktop, example one, yeah, okay. If I close this, yeah, now let's run the presentation. So we go to the desktop and let's find it. Example one, yeah, open in runtime. Come on, there we go. I don't know if you can see it in full screen, so let me just, yeah, so that's the presenter file. You can see that's the end button. Oh, don't know what NVIDIA is coming up. Anyway, yeah, so if I click files, oh, some reason didn't like that. I think the NVIDIA thing stopped it from working. Why is the buttons not working? It's frozen. Is it frozen? I'm not sure why it stopped working. Hang on, let's go back to the... the NVIDIA thing... Nah, it's running on the other monitor. Nah, that's bizarre. Let me go back into Designer and see. Maybe I should update the latest version. Example one. Did I set this? What the hell happened there then? Let me hit save. Let's try it again. Export, presenter, desktop, example one, save. Yeah. I'll just run it. I'll leave Designer open. Some bizarre reason, presenter doesn't respond. That's the first time I've seen it. He is working. I don't know. Maybe it is appear. Is it limited? It can't be locked. I've never seen that before. Close, but it's working. I just don't know why it's not working in presenter right now. Okay, hopefully that helped you. It wasn't too long or boring. It kind of made sense, hopefully. But there's so many ways of making scenes. There's also, I think, if I go, you could do it that way, how I've done it. You can do containers, you can do slide manager, you can do, you can, what you can do, build your stuff in the, what's it called? Each page is a layer if you want it, so if I add a new 3D layer. I swear you can have like a master animation, which is here. So you can have your, you can expose your animations out, and then you can have this master key, master animation, and link your layers together. There's so many ways you can do it, to be honest. You just gotta find out what's, you just gotta experiment. See what's your, what you want. You can also do scene ports. You could have, you could load a scene. So I say, oh, I'll click this, load this scene. example, like if I go here, scene port or scene layer. Yeah, scene port. So you can load another scene within a scene. So if we go here, open widgets. I've got nothing exposed in the scene right now, so. But I can go into it. If I double click, it will open the scene, and you can see I'm inside the scene here. Let's unblock something. Let's expose this target. I'm gonna hit save. Scene save. Go back into here. So now I should have widget. Does it? Did it read it? Let's try it again. Why is this not updating? Let me delete this and add it again. Maybe it'll pick it up, the update. Scene port. Load. Widget. Why is it not seeing the exposed data? Scene is already there, so I skipped. I exposed this out, right? Close. Well, normally what you should see is exposed, what's exposed in that scene. Which is bizarre. I was expecting to see that. I don't know why I can't see it. Or do you have to expose something? Here, maybe you have to expose the layer. Let me just check. Might be different in version 5. Yeah. So in 5, you now have to expose to, out of this the layer for it to see in the scene port here. So now if I click here, you can see that's that graphic in the other scene, within this scene. And then I could link it, so if I say, okay, close button, bring on this widget or something, I don't know. Oh, but right now I have it as a boolean. So I just say touch pressed or something, it'll just bring it on. Hey, double click this, hit okay. Then it'll let me use it. They say touch pressed, so if I hold down, yeah, so if I hold down on this button, it will just check it. So touch pressed, release, and that's a scene port. And then this is the scene itself, same scene. Yeah, but that's a scene within a scene. Yeah, there's so many ways you can do it. I just guess you gotta experiment and find what works best for you. But also, don't forget Ventuz. Check out their website. on the YouTube channel, Ventuz. So we're going to hear Ventuz. I forget, they have tutorials. Alright, here we go, videos. Oh no, playlist. Yeah, here, you've got the overview stuff. I'm sure you've watched them all. But, and they explain the external data logic, all of that. But where is it? Is it playlist? 5 tutorials. Where is it? Where's the tutorials? There's how to, there's a designer tutorials. There we go. Is this it? Yeah. If you go version 4 and 5, they may look different. However, the logic is still the same and the same principle. So this logic animation, this is the same as interface looks different, but it's still some nodes, it still works similar, so it's definitely worth checking out, keyframing and all of this. So go through the YouTube channel and check these, they might help you as well. But I'm going to call it a night. It's nearly 8 o'clock. I hope that was some help. It was a short stream, I'm afraid. So I'm going to head off. Oh, third day of boring old shop. Oh man. Everyone just came as I was finished. I was just answering someone's question on YouTube. They wanted to know how to transition. So he asked me here. He was like, it had to be transition, and I was trying to explain that you could use slide managers, or you could make your own transitions by doing keyframe and animating, or you could load multiple scenes using scene ports. Depends on what you want to do. But I don't know if he's all caught that. I haven't been paying attention. Yeah. But I want to play some game now. So you guys want to play some game? I don't know if you want to play something. I feel like playing some Rainbow Six. Well, hopefully. How long have I been streaming for? Hour. So I'll try to explain it over an hour. Just finished my backup with my okay. Let me see. Where's my Siege games play. But yeah, I'm sorry if you've just appeared now. Everything's my back now. Oh man. But hopefully, what's tomorrow? Thursday will probably be. I can do one more stream. So if you have anything you want me to build, let me know. Or try to answer, but it has to be short because I'm only doing it in the evening. And then Saturday I'm not here, I'm going to Barcelona for the day, and then Sunday will be my day off, and then Monday I go back to work. Can you build me a Ferrari? I can download a Ferrari for you, if that helps. Can download it. Where's my controller? But if anyone wants to come on Rainbow Six, play for a bit, feel free. I need to change this. Please wait. Okay, validating. Let's switch from desktop to game capture. Controller plugged in. Yeah. What's this? Some new stuff. New colors available. Oh, it's not new. Play some casual warm up. Oh, this is a clan I'm in. Well,
increased surveillance on joined
the match. Oh, they're coming from construction. Damn it. They shot all the cameras out straight away. Let's see what these guys are doing. Oh wow, they're dying. That's not good. Nice. Wow, they're just coming from over. This guy won't get off the camera. Boom. Castle's dead. He's planting right in front of him.
Hang in there.
Okay, looks like these guys might have this round. Just drowned him. Ooh. 3 versus 2.
One friendly operator remaining.
Okay, 3 versus 1. You did. Yep.
Mission failed. All friendlies have been neutralized.
Shot in the back. The sledge. Oh, should I go Hibana? What's the time now?
Need to use your drone to locate a bomb.
Might end the stream. It's very much of me playing Rainbow Six is boring. I'm not gonna lie. It's boring. I'm boring. Guy shooting the thing.
Ten seconds. Drone has located a bomb. Insertion in 5 seconds. The diffuser has been recovered. You found a bomb. Make your way to its location and defuse it. Must recover the diffuser. The diffuser is now secured.
On the PlayStation, I can hit those cameras one shot. Okay. I'm gonna go into the thing. To the boathouse. What the heck happened to him?
The diffuser has been secured. You have located a bomb.
On the window, please.
Oh, wow! We got a little blizzard today. A little snow, high wind, which reminds me of... Fetch a bucket full of snow. Oh, that's a good way to keep your Pepsi,
Friendly mission successful.
chilled. Okay, bloody, he one shot me, he just looked. Oh, really? Today's just actually been warm. It's not too cold here. Let's go over to. Oh, what happened here? What happened to my game? There we go. My OBS has disappeared. My chat's disappeared.
Protect the bombs.
Protect the bombs. Let's go over to Jules and see if she wants to play Rainbow Six. I'm gonna try host. Let's try host. Okay. Twitch. So it'd be like this.
10 seconds. 5 seconds to insertion. Op 4 has located a bomb. Get ready to engage.
Let's go over there.